Hello, Pythoneer. Welcome to 13 Things You Should Know About Python Lists. In this video, we'll go through 5 groups of list techniques with 13 ways to work with lists. By the end of it, you'll have practical tools and knowledge to level up your Python skills. Let's not waste any time and start exploring these essential list techniques. At the end, we do a short summary. The first group is about basic list manipulation. You can combine lists using the start operator. Given 2 lists, you can merge them by passing each list with a star operator in front. You can also include manual values either after or within the combined lists. When we print this new list using print combined and run the code, the 2 lists are successfully combined, and the new value 50 is added at the end. It's great for merging data sources in applications like combining user lists. We can insert an item at a specific index in a list. Given a list pets, we simply use the insert function to add a new value at the index we can define, here 1. Then we add a new value like parrot. When we print this updated list using print pets and run the code, we see the new value inserted at index 1 in the pets list. This is useful when you need precise control over item placement, like adding options in ordered menus. We can extend a list with another list using the extend function. Given 2 lists, like base and extras, we say base and then can call the extend function on the base list and passing the extra list to it. When we print the extended base list and run the code, the extra list is added at the end to the base list. This is ideal for appending data from multiple sources, such as combining multiple records. We can replace items in a list at specific indexes using slicing. Given a list of animals, we can simply take this list and define the index range to update and assign it a new list with the new items to. When we print the new animals list and run the code, we see the values at indexes 1 and 2 are replaced with new ones. This is, for example, handy for updating specific portions of data, like changing elements within a sequence of events. We can use negative indices to access elements from the end of the list. Given a list of letters, we can say, print the letter of the letters list at index minus 1 to access the last item, or letters at index minus 2 to access the second to last item. When we run this code, we see we get printed the letter D for index minus 1 and letter C for index minus 2. This can be perfect for quickly accessing the last few elements in scenarios like analyzing recent records. That's it for group 1. In the next one, we see 2 list sorting techniques. We start with the difference between the sort function and the sorted function. I show you both on the given items list. With the sorted function, you need to create a new list by passing the original list inside sorted to it. When you run the code, only the new list is sorted, as you can see here in the right output. To sort the original list in place, use the sort function directly on the original list. When we run this, we see the original list is now sorted. This is, for example, great for choosing between creating sorted versions or sorting in place, especially when dealing with large datasets. You can perform custom sorting using the sort function. Given a list of scores, we can simply call sort on a list and pass a function to it using the key parameter, as shown here. For example, this lambda function sorts the list based on the last digit of each number. When we run the code, we see that the list is sorted by the last digit of the values. This can be useful for flexible sorting in situations like sorting by custom criteria, e.g. priority levels. Before we go any further, let me thank you for watching this far. If you haven't already, please like, subscribe, and hit that bell so you never miss another video from me. Now, let's dive into the next group, where it's all about list unpacking techniques. We can unpack items in a list using the star operator. Given a list called cat, you can unpack its elements into separate variables like name and age, while using star fav food to collect the remaining items into a list. When we now print name, age, and fav food and run the code, we see the unpacked values for name and age and the remaining items from favfood as a new list. This can be useful for handling variable length lists like data imports with flexible fields. We can unpack a list and use it as function arguments with the star operator. In example, given a function that takes A, B, and C as parameters, we can use an f-string to format and print their input values. When we now create a list with 1, 2, and 3, and pass it to the function using the star operator in front, we can unpack these values and match it to the input params. When we run this, the list is unpacked and its values are matched to A, B, and C in the output. This is handy for passing dynamic data into functions, such as when working with API data. Group 4 is all about iterating over lists. We can use the zip function to iterate over multiple lists at the same time. For example, given the two lists fruits and colors, we can run a for loop using the zip function to combine them. Inside the loop, each pair of values from fruits and colors will be matched by their index. Then we use an f-string to print each fruit along with its corresponding color. When we run the code, we see each fruit paired with its color in the output. Ideal for paired data, like item property lists, e.g. product name and price, we can use a enumerate function on a list to access both the index and the value. Given a list of items, we can create a for loop for index and item using enumerate, where we pass the items list to. Then, we can print both the index and the item. When we run the code, each item in the list is printed alongside its index. Useful when you need both the index and value, such as assigning IDs to items. In this group, we see some advanced list techniques. We can search for the minimum and maximum values in a list. Given a list of temperatures, inside a print statement, we use the min function to find the smallest value and the max function to find the largest value inside the temperatures list. When we run the code, we get back the minimum and maximum values. This can be essential for statistical analysis, like quickly assessing a dataset's range. And this is the last one. We can use list comprehension with conditional transformation. Given a list of numbers, we can create a new list of squares where we run inside square number for number in numbers if the number is even. This is done using a condition if the number divided by 2 leaves no remainder. When we print the new list and run the code, all even numbers are squared and printed to the console. This can be great for generating transformed data concisely, like filtering and modifying lists in one line. Are you a fan of list comprehensions? What's a common use case for you? Before we end this, let's wrap it up in a summary. If you made it until here, you have seen 13 powerful list techniques in Python that every programmer should know. Understanding these methods gives you the power to handle data more flexibly and write cleaner, more efficient code, whether you're just starting out or brushing up on your Python skills. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button to stay updated on more tips like these. And let's keep the learning going. Let me know in the comments which technique you liked best, or share your own favorite list trick. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next video.